site analysis diagrams are one of the first types of drawings you will have to do for a new architectural, urban, or landscape project. A simple and effective illustration that you can do using Photoshop. In this video, I want to show you how to quickly create a diagram like this, starting from Google Earth in 3 simple steps. I want to give you the skills that will allow you to be creative and adapt this to any site. Oh, and be sure to watch to the end of the video because there's a bonus trick there. Step 1, the base. Now, the results will vary depending on your site location, right? So I want to show you the essential techniques so you can take this further and apply to your needs. Now, the Google Earth image we can get from the website, Google Earth, but from here, you will need to print screen to grab the image as there's no way to export a high resolution image, which is totally okay as long as you have a high resolution screen. For example, I have here a 4K screen, so a print screen means a 4K resolution image, and Google Earth has all the quality, and it will display that in 4K. But, and what I've always used in the past, I prefer to use the actual Google Earth Pro, which is a standalone program that I can export an image file and choose from many different resolutions. On both occasions, make sure that you turn off all of the labels and enable the 3D buildings. Now, depending on the location of your site in the world, the quality of the Google Earth image may vary, but it's not so much of a problem as it was in the past, where there was some clear favoritism for developed countries or regions. Now, if you're on the web page, be sure to change the quality to max, and then set the map to clean. Okay, so last tip, before we move on to Photoshop, pick an angle that favors your site and the whole narrative that you have going on for your project. Something slightly tilted, but not too much as well. I want to see the 3D buildings, but not the horizon. By the way, can you guess where I'm located here on the map? Be sure to comment down below. Okay, so I'll go to File, Save, and then Save Image, and choose the correct setting for me, like disabling all of the map options and picking 4K resolution, which is more than enough, to be honest. Okay, so here in Photoshop, let's finalize what I'm calling the base. So create a new layer, and fill it with white, then lower the opacity to say 50%. For now at least, this process is non-destructive, so you can always come back later and refine these values. From here, create a mask on this white filled layer so we can carve out the site. Well, in this case, I'm assuming that I have a large intervention area and there are multiple sites along it. A typical project in the final years of architecture school. Now you could just use a brush and start painting here, but I find that a clean and sharp selection makes a better result. So I prefer to tackle this using the polygonal lasso tool, which I know can be tedious, but gives you a perfect selection. Take your time here, and I like to select around the buildings and vegetation to accommodate this selection to what's actually there in 3D. So the whole white field effect feels even more properly placed than just straight lines and simple selection. I use the add mode to continue with the same selection until I have everything I need selected. And keep in mind that this is just the first pass on the selection. We can come back then refining this, adding or removing areas as necessary. That's the beauty of using masks. Okay, so once the selection is done, make sure the mask is selected and then fill this selection with black so that it hides this white fill where needed. Nice, right? Now, to finalize this space, I like to add a few adjustments to the Google Earth photo so that we fade a bit of this information, and later when we layer the other stuff, it doesn't get too overwhelming. So with the base image selected, add a hue and saturation adjustment layer, and I'm taking the saturation by a lot here. And then add a levels adjustment and bring these two slider heads closer together. And what this does is just reduce the contrast of the image, bringing the black values up and the white values down. But since I don't want these adjustment layers to affect everything in the image, we can Alt and then drag the mask from the white fill layer to these adjustments so that it's also masked out on the areas needed. Pretty cool, right? We can use that information to apply to other adjustments and other layers. Even without the white field, this already looks quite interesting, and we have now successfully separated the intervention area, or it could be just the site itself, from the surroundings. And this completes step 1, now on to step 2, working on the site. 2 things we can do here. Sometimes the actual site you'll be working has buildings, or it just isn't as flat or empty as you would like it to be. So I like to pick the colors from the site to paint over it and create this flat surface. There's no recipe here, to be honest. It's definitely sort of a painting job, but what I make sure is that I have the same selection from the white fill mask so that everything lines up correctly. Use soft brushes, add shadows where necessary, and really make this feel like it's part of the Google Earth photo. Your job doesn't have to be perfect anyway, as you're gonna have the white fill helping you make this look right. After it's done, to add more texture, you can add a bit of grain to break this soft surface, and that's it. Now, even though we have the intervention area masked out, we can go even further and highlight the actual site. There are many ways you can do this, but I like to use the pen tool. And depending on your base, like the Google Earth photo you have, you can use blend modes like overlay. And the overlay blend mode can also be used in a new layer, and with a simple brush, you can make custom painted areas. Sometimes you need this flexibility of a brush that a shape can't give you. For this one, I'll leave it at normal though, because of this shadow I have here from this tall building. Okay, that's how we work on the site. Now let's move to the final part of this tutorial, step 3, details. From here, there are so many things you could add to this diagram. Each site will obviously demand a different set of data added here, and in this video I want to show you a few possibilities. For example, it's quite common to need to add titles and description to certain parts of the diagram. So creating a tag or a callout can be a good alternative. This can be done using shapes, a pen tool, a brush, or a mix of everything. The only thing I would look for is to have individual layers for each of these elements. And I would go the extra step of categorizing the layers into folders and color coding them. Since the background here, or better, the base image is full of information, even after we added all of that fading effect with the adjustment layer, laying some text over it isn't really a good idea. So try using shapes to box these texts. With one ready, then it's quite easy to just duplicate, for example, this entire folder, and then just change the information as needed. As an extra touch and to give a bit more of a 3D feel, I'm adding a base to this line using a distorted brush. Then on the same idea of adding a perspective circle, let me show you how to add those radius elements to this diagram. For this, I like to use shapes so that we're able to scale this back and forth without losing quality. And with a perfect circle, I can use the transform box, Ctrl T to distort this so that it fits into the base perspective, as if this was laid flat on the ground. More or less, it's really hard to get this perfect, especially because there's a lot of distortion in the base, and the more we look here to the right, the more angled the buildings are to the right, and the same happens to the left. So if possible, with your location, try using the city blocks as guides to make this fit right. And then once this looks okay, you can then hold Shift and Alt while scaling this down so that it maintains the distortion. For the radius element, I like to have a strong and solid center. I'm adding a color now, but I'll show you how to easily change the colors later. So make sure you have a copy of the shape, using Ctrl J for that. And now scale it up to create the radius. Since this is a shape, I can use the shape properties to change this from a fill to a stroke, and even change the line type to dashed, for example. I'm not too sure about the green color yet, but again, this can be changed later. I'll do a second ring here, and the correct scale or size of this can be tricky. Since we are in perspective, there's no way to make this up to scale. So what I have done in the past and what I suggest is to have the site plan or the base surroundings plan up to scale in either CAD or BIM to understand until where these circles should go, and then you replicate it here. The level of precision is not going to be the same, but it's about showing this data in addition to everything else you're adding to this diagram. Now, sometimes I also like to change the small dot in the middle to overlay so that it blends better with the base. From here, you can add text and the distance line as needed, or even highlight important buildings that are part of this area or radius analysis. And here's a really good tip on how to easily change the color of all of these elements at once. You're gonna create a solid color above the folder, and this is also why it's good to work with folders. And then you're gonna clip this solid layer to the folder with the shortcut Ctrl-Alt-G, so that the solid layer only affects the elements inside the folder. Now you simply change the color here to change on all of the layers. Okay, moving on, and remember that there are many options on how to add information to this image. Sometimes I like to work with a brush with a thin white line to add extra details. For example, it could be an indication of some massing that will be added to the intervention area. I like this mix of sharp, precise lines of the elements I added earlier with this more hand-drawn feel with these white lines. Just be aware of the weird perspective on the base, the fact that the vertical lines are not straight. Good drawing skills definitely come in handy at this point in the process, and shorter buildings are going to be easier to make it look good. What I also like to do is use white lines, but also faded white fills to give even more weight to these volumes. And lastly, since we're talking about details, and maybe referring back to the whole terrain fixing part we did, take advantage of the base image. For example, to add some vegetation to the newly painted site, I copy it from the base and then paste it on a new layer, duplicate it as needed to create this texture, and then with a mask, paint in where needed. Then don't forget to add some shadows to make this feel in place. Alright, to end this video, here are two bonus tricks you can do. One is to then Ctrl+Shift+Alt+E to create a copy of everything on top of your layer stack. And I like to convert this to a smart object as well. And then you can do all sorts of stuff to this composition, the camera filter that I always mention, but for example, add an iris blur to shift the focus towards the center of the image. And the cool thing about this blur is that it's a gradient of a blur. Quite nice, right? And then a second bonus is that you can add more effects to the elements. For example, I can quickly and easily add a drop shadow effect directly to the folder so that it applies over all of the elements. In this case here, helping the radius pop even more. Just be subtle though. And then any element you don't want this effect applied, you just remove from the folder. Alright, after a few more tweaks, here it is. And you can even try different color combinations quite easily with that trick I showed you. From a simple Google Earth image to a detailed aerial diagram. Don't forget to subscribe to not miss any future videos, and YouTube seems to think you'd like this recommended video, so click it to continue learning.